A person who speaks the truth is always hated by others because they show others what they are running away from. They just show others the mirror. And when the people get triggered, the others become a channel for their inner hate. So in a way, they are not hating that person. They simply hate the truth. And the reason for this hate towards truth is the split in consciousness of the masses. We live in a world where we are encouraged to be a hypocrite. We are taught that if you feel a certain way, you don't have to show that feeling, you don't speak your mind, and you act another way. And because of that, we develop so many personalities. And the word personality comes from the root word persona, which literally means a mask. So from our very childhood, we have so many different masks because we have to act a certain way in front of our teachers, our parents, our friends, in front of everyone. We use a different mask, a different personality, and it creates a split in our consciousness. A fragmentation. Now the real problem arises when we completely forget who we really were before all the personalities. Who is the original self, the real you, the authentic you? We not just act differently in front of others, we start identifying ourselves with those masks, with those personalities. This is why the personality of majority of people are not really them. It's not their authentic self who they are living. It's just a perception of them that was imposed upon them by the masses, by the world that we live in. So this is the split in consciousness. And that split is completely rooted in the denial of truth, because you have been constantly taught to go against what you're feeling, to never acknowledge who you are. This is why people make such good hypocrites. They feel a certain way towards a person, but they act completely opposite of that. They want to say no, but they are unable to say. Because they have a program of people pleasing, they have been taught that you have to always say yes to people, never say no, always please people and impress people. And the person who is confidently able to say no, only they can say yes to anything. They can truly commit to anything. So to overcome this split in consciousness, first of all, you have to face yourself. You have to stop lying to yourself. And you have to stop believing what you have told other people about yourself, because those are lies as well. That's just the projection of your persona, of the mask. We have been so obediently following all that because of the authority of the society. From the very childhood, you are given an authority figure. It can be your parents, your teachers. And you are, in a way, taught and groomed to become a servant for the corporate world. And your teachers are replaced by your bosses. And it is just a cycle. So when you see right through this, you realize that the entire system is set up in such a way that they take away your original self, your authentic self. And in a way, that's the spark of your spirit. That's who you truly are. But by creating the split in consciousness, by creating a fragmentation, they take away your individuality. Now you are no longer that empowered, integrated self. You are disempowered because you are fragmented. This is why people carry so many low vibrational energies like fear, shame and guilt within their energy field, because they have this belief that they have to be a people pleaser. They have to hate a certain aspect of themselves. They can't express themselves freely. So this split goes way deeper. It not only stops you from listening to the truth, from facing the truth, it also stops you from evolving and being your authentic self. It takes you in a path that's not truly yours. You end up living someone else's idea of life because you are trying to fulfill an idea of yourself that's not who you truly are. So the key is to stop lying to yourself. It's all about staying true to yourself. No matter where you are, no matter who you are dealing with, always speak your mind, always speak your truth. There is nothing wrong with you. Whatever you feel is completely valid. You are not supposed to act a different way. And this is why hypocrites have so many fake relationships. They have so many fake friends. Because they have an image that by surrounding themselves with more people, they become whole. But that's just a big fat lie. You can't become whole by surrounding yourself with fake people. And on the other hand, the people who speak the truth, they don't have too many friends. They only have a few. But they are real. Because they don't entertain fake energy. So when a person has a split in their consciousness, when their energy is fragmented, they are living a pseudo life, a fake life, a life that's not really theirs, and their authentic self is like asleep. They're trying to fulfill the society's dream through them. They have become kind of a slave of this system. So this is why it is a really good thing that if you are a truth seeker, a truth speaker, because you are here to make a change in the human consciousness. Just by speaking the truth, when you trigger people, you give them a chance to look within themselves. You show them the mirror that this is not who you are. All your personalities are just fragmentations. And the inner journey is all about realizing that who you are beyond all the personalities, beyond all the splits in your consciousness, when you find your true empowered version, which is the true you, which is the unity consciousness, which is one with the entire existence, you experience something which is beyond this time and space. You experience yourself in your absolute purity. So keep speaking the truth and don't worry about what others say about you, because it's just a projection of what's happening within them. Much love to you all.